Okay, that is a new. I think it is Plasma 519, but I have never showed it before, so here it comes. So we open Plasma Calendar, and below we see the events. Everything okay? If we right click and configure, we have an option called Show Local Time Zone. Check that, and after we tap on the annoying apply button, we will see that clock is now displaying our city. It may seem stupid, but it is not. Back on time zones, and let's add some more cities. And hit annoying apply button again, followed with more annoying OK. Perhaps OK alone could work, but who knows anyway? So now on calendar we can see our new place's time zones, but what's most interesting is that if we click on a city, that will automatically become the default of our clock. Which is why the city name option is actually useful. A much better change than this, is if we now click on this tiny arrow to open the indicators, we'll get a complete redesign with boxes instead of vertical lists, which is so much nicer. Now why I have a battery indicator on my desktop? Only a god knows. But one thing I don't like is this mess with the multiple icons on tray, and I prefer some kind of better grouping. Okay, let's bring a terminal here. I made a video on this K1 script previously, but I will upload one a bit more explainful later. And next, one of my favorite new features in Plasma follows. But I found one more cool thing. So if we click Rika, she will open on the image app. But what I want to show you on Gwen view, is that if we full screen it, then it will get that rough background behind, that for some reason I totally love. And that's probably why they removed it from GNOME Login Manager background. But we are not done yet, because we can put one more Rika into the play. I don't have idea what's that, but it looks cool and I will make it video cover too.